My name is RJ, and I'm a soil microbiologist at the Engineering Research Development Center, Coal Regions Research and Engineering Lab. And today, I'm going to talk to you about soil microbial fuel cells. In our field, we often chastise people for calling soil dirt. In fact, dirt is kind of a four-letter word for us in a negative sense. But apart from being kind of a joke, it really actually calling it dirt underlies or belies how complex soil actually is. So for example, in 1 gram of soil, there is over 1 million microorganisms in there, working really hard to keep our ecosystem alive. They perform ecosystem services, they degrade organic matter. There's a lot of microorganisms in there that perform different things, and some of them can be very useful. In this case, microbial fuel cells, they're actually producing power right now. They're degrading organic matter and they're creating electricity, which is pretty awesome for soil, not dirt. Terrestrial microbial fuel cells are great for producing power in very low amounts, but they can do more than that. They are living organisms that are producing power, and they can be impacted by the environment. So let's say, for example, they get slimed with something that's toxic to them. That will change how much voltage they're producing. And if we're able to use that voltage in a characteristic way, we can actually tell what it's exposed to and kind of backtrack. So they can function as clandestine sensors for human presence. But it's gonna take a lot of work because we need to figure out how they respond to certain chemicals, and we're using machine learning techniques to actually kind of use pattern recognition to uncover these voltage patterns as they change. And in that way, we're making our armed forces safer.